Welcome to raigurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about user acceptance testing, which is a very important part of every software development life cycle. So we'll see here what is user acceptance testing, why we need UAT, how to perform UAT, when is it performed, UAT process, types of UAT and their challenges. First of all, what is user acceptance testing or UAT? This is a type of testing performed by the end user or the beta customer of any organizations. The client wants to verify or accept the software system before moving the software application into production. Sometimes end user is doing this testing, or sometimes we have the in-house UAT testing team to perform this activity. UAT is done in the final phase of testing after functional integrations and system testing is done, where the tester or testing team is verifying complete functionality based on business requirement document or based on business related use cases. So if you want to learn the complete process of software testing, please watch my complete playlist of software testing. I will also include the URL in description tab. If you have not yet subscribed this channel, please subscribe and press bell icon for further updates. So why we need UAT? Generally, when software development process start, at the same time BRD documents will be circulated with each and every team, including developer, QA and UAT team. At the time of initiation of UAT processes, there are several business related cases to be done, so that whenever the product will move into the production, that product should have defect free. Software has undergone unit integration and system testing because developers might have built software irrespective of BRD documents or requirement documents by their own understanding, and further required changes during development may not be effectively communicated to them. To avoid these type of scenario or to avoid these type of cases, generally UAT needs to be done. There are two segregations will be there. Either this testing will be done by the end user or client's team, or few of the organizations are having separate UAT team. For that, the UAT team is testing the complete functionality or product functionality based on business related use cases, and these business related use cases will be passed and approved by the end user only or by the product owner. Developers code software based on the requirement document, which is their own understanding. Sometimes they might perceive or they might take on a negative phase or in the other angle or sides of the applications. Because of that, UAT is must requirement component, which may not actually be what the client needs from the software. Requirement changes during the course of the project may not be communicated effectively to the developers. Let's consider two examples here. One, developers have included feature on their own understanding, which might clients not accept it, or if they have concluded only single phase of coin or single side of the coin. But what if we have other sides of the coin, then definitely that should be incorporated. So these type of testings will be performed by the UAT team. Generally, QA team are doing the testing based on the development sides on the functionality only, but business cases wants to be covered by the UAT team only. Second example, let's consider one e-commerce site where clients provided the requirement to build a payment page with credit card, but what if they have just missed to specify the business related case, because this will become a restrictions to the product. So the people or the person who is using this product, they don't have credit card, they won't be able to use that product, which is again a restrictions. So in that case, UAT team will highlight this, and based on that, the development team will make changes. Now, how to perform UAT? UAT is done by the intended user of the software or systems. This type of software testing usually happens at the client locations, but again, that is not mandatory because some of these client locations don't have the UAT testing team. So this will be performed by the either third party or the in-house team of the developer side. Generally, this is also called as beta testing. Once entry criteria of UAT are satisfied, there are different aspects to be covered at the time of UAT. First is analysis of business requirement. The BRD requirement or documents which we receive from the end user, first UAT team has to analyze that document. Based on the analysis, they will share the analysis report. If the complete all the stakeholders will be okay, then they will start creating UAT test plan, which will cover entry and exit criteria, then the complete durations, how much time they will take, which all resources will be there, which all environments will be required. So these all will be mentioned in the UAT test plan. If you don't know about test plan, please watch test plan video from my software testing playlist. Now, to identify the test scenarios, UAT team lead will start writing or drafting the test scenario, and once the test scenario and test cases will be done, the requirement traceability matrix will be prepared. Based on the requirement traceability matrix, all the scenarios and test cases will be shared to the end user for the final approval. If any changes are required, end user will confirm on the change specific. Otherwise, if they are fine with the test plan and test scenarios, then they will approve. Post that preparation of test data, and at the end, running of test cases will be done. All the UAT team will record in terms of either via recording or generating a screenshots. Post that they will confirm the business objective. So this is how we can perform UAT at user end side. Now let's discuss in detail which we have looked on the analysis of business requirement. So initially the UAT team will plan and analyze the primary sources of input information which they have received. If few of the informations are missing, they will reach out to the end users and ask for the more requirement documents. If something is confusing, they will ask for the clarifications. Generally, these type of meetings will be called, and within that meetings, they will specify what they have understand, and based on that, they will start preparing test scenarios and test cases. These test scenarios will cover each and everything about the user and perspective, and business scenarios will be included. After that, they will create a complete test plan and prepare test data. And finally, once the approval will be received, they will start executing the test cases. At the same time, best practices is to automate UAT test scenarios so that whenever they will receive frequent builds, they will perform this testing frequently or on quick basis via using automation. Now, after confirming the business objective met, this product will be moved into the pre-production environment, and from there onwards, end user will take it ahead. Now, when we will need UAT to be done? Generally, when the process hasn't started, UAT team will start working on the different stages which we have discussed in earlier slides. This is a very critical phase of software development and change implementations. It should run after unit testing, so our development teams are satisfied their code works as expected and successful QA testing. Once the QA team will provide the go-ahead, then UAT team will start running or executing the test cases, and based on the business requirement, they will verify each and every cases, and boundary value analysis post that they will declare. If they will found any defect, they will raise the defect and try to fix it. Post that they will receive any intermediate bills, and once the verification is done, all looks fine, then they will proceed into the production environment. Now, which all types of UAT to be performed? Generally, UAT is done on the other side of functionality, that is related to business requirement documents as well as the boundary value analysis. Based on the business requirement documents, UAT team will start working into it. So first is user acceptance testing, then business acceptance testing, that is called as BAT. Contract acceptance testings, if they have any payments or financial related transactions, terms and conditions or any manual guides that needs to be tested. Then regulation based on the compliance and InfoSec regulations, these needs to be performed. Operational acceptance testing and alpha and beta testing, these all are the part of UAT testing. Now, which all challenges of UAT will have? Generally, first challenge is in test planning. If UAT team are not planned well at the time of planning, then software development lifecycle, any delays in previous stages mean less time and more pressure to complete the stage faster. And generally, if this will happen, the UAT team will be on pressure and chances of missing the defects will be more. So it needs to be planned according to software development, and the proper development time should be allotted to each of the functionality. Then bad choice of UAT resources. So this is best fit when we have a team members in different domain. Let's say if team are a few of the team members are from the banking and finance domain, and this project is from the, or current project is from the media domain. So in that case, the banking and finance domain's team members don't have the complete visibility of media domain. So in that case, this will be possible. They might miss few of the scenarios which is required to be done. If our test cases and test plans are not well equipped, they will definitely miss this scenario. Testing environment and deployment. Using the same environment that was with functional testing and systems testing could lead software dependencies in that particular environment. So this is generally preferable to have a separate environment for the UAT, which is exactly a replica of our production environment. Now, next is communication gap. Gap in communication between UAT and testing teams could cause delays or problems with reporting of bugs for testing scenarios. Team needs to ensure that every communication is to be delivered to the product owner and user as well as all the stakeholders, including them. If they have many scenarios or many findings, they will get together, they will connect together and discuss about the findings. If end user is fine, there is no issue. If end user is expecting to log a defect, they should log a defect accordingly. So that's all from the UAT testing. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you think so, we should cover lot any other things in this video, please drop in comment sections. And if you think so, this will be valuable, don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.